studying Zen at a real temple is a great experience, and one of my favorite parts of it is the eating tradition of Ōryōki in three bowls. Hi, I'm Patrick, and today we're going to go into the details of Ōryōki three-bowl eating and talk about how you can bring some of these things into your own daily life. When you do a Zen retreat, you use one Ōryōki set for the entire time. As you can see, an Ōryōki set consists of a large white cloth, square in shape, smaller cloth, chopsticks, and what looks like one bowl becomes three. All meals are served and eaten in silence. In this eating tradition, you always show respect to the food and the server who brings it by bowing deeply with a gassho. The largest bowl is always used for rice. Because this is a silent practice, when the server has given you enough, you simply raise your fingers like this, never taking more than you can actually eat. The medium-sized bowl is always used for miso soup. As before, when the server has given you enough, you simply raise your fingers. The final, smallest bowl is for pickles. Japanese pickles can be made of any number of things, from daikon, radish, to spring onions, to ginger. They're great for cleansing the palate, and as you'll see later, have a special use in this Ōryōki style. Now that everything's been served, we can eat with a quiet appreciation for the food that gives us life. So now I've finished eating, and the next step is to wash my bowls in preparation for the next meal. The server brings hot water, which he or she pours into the largest bowl. You might notice that I've eaten everything except for one large, in this case, takuan pickle. I'm going to use this pickle as kind of a sponge, mixing it with the hot water and scrubbing it around, knocking off any loose rice or anything left over from my meal. The acidity of the pickle also serves to neutralize germs. From here, I pour the water, pickle and all, into the medium-sized bowl. Now, taking that second cloth, which we've had from the beginning, I'm going to wipe and dry the largest of the bowls. The steps are repeated for the second bowl, this time pouring the leftover water into the smallest pickle bowl. You'll notice that we're all out of bowls now, so what am I going to do with this water? Well, in the Ōryōki tradition, nothing is wasted. This last bit of water is given to the hungry ghosts, or gaki. Those are souls who weren't satisfied in their previous life and who now wander, trying to be released from this world. Taking the water, I respectfully pour it into a separate container. Later, this water will be poured into the ground or left outside for the ghosts to enjoy. So, all the bowls are now dry and clean, and I've put them back together. The last step is to repack everything so it's nice and neat for the next meal. Holding up the second napkin, putting it aside with the chopsticks, I'm going to open it up to a full square and fold the top and the bottom down into the socket of the bowl. From here, rest the chopsticks on top along with the napkin. The next step may look really fancy, but it's just an elaborate way to tie a knot. As you tie the knot, the chopsticks and the second napkin will be sucked down into the bowl and everything will become really compact. Tie one more knot to secure it all, and we're ready to go. This Ōryōki eating style is characterized by lack of waste and mindfulness, two things which we could use a lot more of in this world.